Hello and welcome to Team VLSI channel. Today, in continuation with the previous session, we will talk about RTL-to-GDSII flow. In this session, we will talk about physical design flow. So please like the video and subscribe the channel. So let's start the session. In the previous session, we have generated the gate level netlist and also checked the logical equivalence in formality. So we have done the logical equivalence check and it is correct. So now we can proceed further. So we will see here in this session the physical design flow. First we will see the flow, then we will move to the tool, physical design tool, that is Innovus, and we will do the hands-on. So before that, we need to once see the its flow of Innovus. First, what is physical design? Physical design is a process of transforming synthesized gate level netlist into layout. A GDSII database can be generated from the layout, which is required for foundry to fabricate the chip. And physical design is often referred as PnR or automatic PnR in industry. Main steps in physical design are placement of logical cells, clock tree synthesis, routing. We also optimize the area, power and performance during the physical design. Next is, what are the inputs and outputs files in physical design? So first we will see the list of input and output files. Detailed discussion will be done in later. So very first thing is, very first input in the physical design flow is synthesized gate level netlist. Got it from design compiler after the synthesis of our RTL. So it is a .v file. Next thing comes physical library. For Innovus, we need .lef format of physical library. In this physical library, we have layouts of all the standard cells, pads, etc. Next thing is IO pad assignment file. It is optional. If you have IO pads in your design, then you may make a IO pad assignment file, which will directly place your IO. So next thing is our timing library. It is a part of our technology library. So timing library, here we in Innovus tool, for PnR tool, we will use .lib format of timing library, which will help to set the multi-mode, multi-corner setups in which our there are requirement of setup and hold times, and so we need a set of timing library like fast library, slow library and typical library. All the things comes under the timing library. And the next thing is our constant file. Constant file, here we got from the design compiler itself. In the beginning of design compiler, we have given the constraint for synthesis. Then its output also is a SDC file or constant file, which we will use here. So these are the set of input files which will go to the PnR tool. Here we are using the Innovus as a PnR tool. Innovus is a product of Cadence, and similar PnR tools which is being used in industry are ASIC compiler from Synopsys and Olympus SoC of Mental Graphics. Okay, so next, to run the PnR tool, generally we make a script to run all these steps inside the PnR tool, which is very fast and easy to operate. Other way might be we use UI of the tool and do the all the steps one by one, but industry generally prefer the script, so we require a Innovus step script. It is in .tcl format. I will show later the scripts, and we will talk about what inside this script are generally we write. So now we are ready to do the PnR flow. So after doing the PnR, we will get a GDS2 file, which is the final output of our IC design flow. So let's now see the steps in a bit details. So very first step of physical design is design initialization itself. So design inside the design initialization, we do the design import, then we create and load floor plan, then we set the timing mode setups. Inside the timing mode setups, we have set lot of timing library for multi-mode, multi-corner setups. So after that, we move to the next stage, which is called pre-CTS flow. So inside the pre-CTS flow, we have to do scan definition, then cell placement, plus pre-CTS optimization. And then we will check the timing. If timing met, then we will move forward. Else, we have to do again these pre-CTS steps. So if timing met, we move to the next stage, which is called post-CTS flow. So inside the post-CTS flow, first thing which we have to do is clock tree synthesis. So we will do the clock tree synthesis here first, and then post CTS setup fixing. We'll do the setup timing fixing here, then post CTS hold fixing. Okay, so after CTS, we did the setup and hold fixing. Now we'll check the timing requirement. If timing doesn't meet, then we have again repeat these steps until our timing meet. And once the timing meet, we move to the next stage, which is called post route flow. So inside the post route flow, first of all, we will do the routing. So after routing, we will get the actual routing metals on the layout. So first thing is routing here, then next post route setup and hold optimization, then again we will check the timing requirement. If it met, then only we move the next stage, else we have to repeat these steps until the timing requirements met. So next stage is our final stage, is called sign off. So inside the sign off, we have first fill the fillers. So add fillers, then we will do the physical verification. So inside the physical verification, we check DRC, LVS, ERC, antenna violence violations, many things we'll check here. Then next stage is timing analysis. So after the final timing analysis here, after doing all the things, then we will again check the timing. If timing met, then we will move forward, else we have to repeat again these steps. So let's timing, let's suppose the timing is met, then next stage is our sign off. So that is, we will generate the GDS2 from here. Okay, so once we reach this stage, sign off, our flow is complete. So our physical design flow is completed, and our GDS2 will be sent to the foundry. So thank you, for watching this video. Please do like this video and subscribe the channel, and you also can comment or post your queries in the comment section. I will revert back to you. Thanks for watching.